carbon composition resistors. Now, this is the cross-sectional view of carbon composition resistors. You can see here, there is a core here, right? In this, carbon particles with non-conducting binder, that is clay. So, this is the main portion where the resistance is created. Now, here, this lead wire is, fixed into the, embedded into the, this core material. So, and then entire this core is in a, put in a molded case, which is normally of ceramic or sometimes plastic. So, the greatest advantage of carbon composition resistor is its ability to withstand high energy pulses. That is the greatest advantage. Ability to withstand high energy pulses. So, the problem, the difference here is in wire wound case, only resistors are the sources of resistive wire is the source of, heat generation. And then that heat conduction also, unfortunately, resistors on that wire only will conduct higher than the rest of the material. So, it is local. But in carbon case, entire carbon composition body conducts the energy. Energy means heat energy. Unlike the wire wound resistor, which has a much smaller volume of the wire to conduct. This is the main difference. That's why it has high energy density also. So, high energy pulses, like high voltage pulses, can be, it can withstand. Hence, carbon composition resistor has much higher thermal mass. This is called thermal mass. Consequently, high energy capability. This is the difference. Then, disadvantages of carbon composition resistors. So, low stability of the resistance value. So, R can change up to 5% per year of usage. So, this is one problem as it contains materials with different heat expansion. So, the problem here is the the resistance is achieved by mixing the carbon particles in a clay insulating material. So, what happens is different materials when you mix them, they have different expansion coefficients and when you are using, it will be heated up and then cool down. So, cool down. So, what happens in during the process, over a period of time, the resistance value changes. So, this is one problem. And insulation resistance is actually poor, 10 to the power of 9 ohms. So, it's for achieving higher resistances, it is difficult actually. Now, one more problem is high temperature coefficients of around 1200 ppm per degree centigrade. And beyond 70 degree centigrade, it gets derated. So, this is another problem. So, actually these resistors are not suitable for high precision electronic applications, but electrical application, high voltage application, we are mainly concerned about this problem, one problem, self-inductance, self-capacitance and then high energy capacity, that is very important compared to wire wound. So, that is one thing in favor of carbon composition resistors. Now, next is, carbon film or metal film or metal oxide resistors. So, all of them have, similar construction. That's why I have given only one figure, which can explain the constructional details of all others also. So, here you can see there are end caps here and then there is a lead wire. And here, this is carbon film. This is carbon film you are seeing, right? And centrally, there is a ceramic carrier. I hope you are watching this one. This is a ceramic carrier. So, this green color so is a ceramic carrier above which carbon film is coated. And above this film, again, it is ceramic material is coated. Now you can see in the carbon film, there are helical cuts here and there. So this is a helical cut. So you can clearly see how it is, the grooves you can see. So it is actually looks like a wire wound like this, right? This is wire wound like this. But the inductance values are, you know, not comparable to wire wound resistors, because this is a strip. This is a strip, and the number of strips will be very small. So normally the self inductance is neglected in this case. This is a significant improvement on carbon composition resistor. And one more advantage is the operating voltages are up to 10 to 15 kilovolts with nominal temperature of 350 degree centigrade. So this is the interesting thing. So for high voltage application, it is very good. Used in high voltage power supplies, radar and X-rays and laser. However, the metal film, so that we are going to discuss in the next slides, and metal oxide film are not too expensive to produce and have overall better properties compared to this one. So one more thing, the appearance of metal film resistors is similar to carbon film resistors, but their properties for stability, accuracy and reliability are considerably better. So that we will cover in the next few slides. So carbon film, metal film and metal oxide film resistors. This is carbon film, right? So similarly, metal film, metal oxide film will be there, will look like similar, but the procedure of processing or construction is different. That is not in the scope of this lecture. So now let us see metal film and metal oxide film resistors. Metal oxide film resistors have a thin metal layer. So instead of that carbon layer, you have thin metal layer as resistive element on a non-conducting axial cylindrical body. So actually there is a confusion here. People will normally get confused. Metal film resistors and then thin film resistor. What are these differences? The difference is metal film resistors, when we say it is normally, most often it is cylindrical axial body on which it is done, and thin film when you say it is on a chip, that I will show you in a few slides. So I have a thin metal layer as resistive element on a non-conducting axial cylindrical body, right? Then metal film resistors have good characteristics for tolerance, stability, low temperature coefficient, low noise and high linearity because of low voltage coefficients. You know, voltage dependence is also very, very important, because for high voltage people, this is also important. The metal film resistors, they are better than, you know, carbon film resistors on these several, you know, properties. Therefore, in circuits where tight tolerance and low temperature coefficient and low noise are important, then in that case, this kind of metal film resistors will be used. Next, metal oxide film resistor. Metal oxide, normally tin oxide is used. Film resistors are even better performance compared to metal film, such as power rating, voltage rating, overload capability, surge capability, high temperature performance, etc. Metal oxide film resistors are preferred for high endurance, long term purposes, but the stability properties are not so good, metal oxide compared to metal film. The metal oxide film resistors have poor properties for low R values, low resistance values, and the temperature coefficient, if you compare, which is higher than for metal film type. So these are different characteristics. And what are thin film and thick film? So thick film normally refers to a chip type of construction like this. So on the chip, very thin layer, this thin film is used for 0.1 microns and thick film is about 100 microns thick layer that is used. So on this substrate, it is called, on this substrate, this either 0.1 microns or 100 microns, using different techniques, a layer will be deposited, and then that layer will be etched using lasers in a very fine lines, and then achieving required resistance values. So these are, you know, highly accurate and then normally used for electronic applications. For high voltage applications, unfortunately, these cannot be used because there may be breakdown between the adjacent layers, which are separated by a very small distance. So when high fields occur inside on the layers, so you know, surface flashover is possible and breakdown is possible. One more aspect I have to tell you on this type of carbon film resistors or metal film resistors. Here also flashover is possible between adjacent layers also. Here also a flashover is possible. So in order to avoid this flashover, what is done is, you know, gap will be increased and then depth of the groove will also be increased. This is for high voltage applications. Special constructions are possible.
This is about carbon film, carbon composite, metal film, metal oxide resistors. Thank you for watching. Please stay tuned.